Hi, I'm Diane from GoNaturalEnglish.com, your personal English coach and motivator. If you've seen my other videos, you know that I am not a native English speaker. I may sound a little bit like one, but today I want to share with you how I became fluent in English. This is my own personal experience. This may not be the same as you learn or the same situation that you are in. I just wanted to share with you how I did it, and maybe it can help some of you guys who had experienced the same things. I'm sure that some of the tricks that I used, you can use as well. It took me a long time to be a fluent English speaker, don't get me wrong. I, who am 27, and my sister, who is 21, we have very different learning speeds. At the time that we came, she was 5, I was 12. So it took me longer than it took my little sister. She learned it so fast, I was in shock. And it took me a little bit longer because I was a little bit older. And I'm sure that once you get even older, even my age, it's a lot harder. But don't get discouraged, it's not impossible. I'm learning another language too. I'm trying to learn Chinese and it's very difficult. Now that I am older, I understand that it's not easy to just completely start again and learn a different language. I know that it's very difficult, but it is not impossible. In the next few minutes, I want to share my story with you and the tips, some tips and tricks that I have used to improve my English. I still have stuff to learn. Don't get me wrong, I don't know everything, but I feel a lot more confident and I know that I can share my knowledge with you guys and help other people improve their English just like I did. Comment below which tips and tricks you have used that have improved your English. I would love to read your comments and maybe other people in the comments will find your tricks useful as well. If you like these English tips, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and take a look at our English course that will help you become a better English speaker. Throughout my videos, I have shared a few things here and there about how I became fluent. And most of my videos are about that, about my personal experience. And in this video, I'll just give you a more detailed version of how I learned English. And this is how the story begins. I started learning English in school back when I was in Colombia. My schools were bilingual, so that means that my classes were in English, like math, science, social studies. And I was able to train my ear in English. I had obviously an English class. And I remember how obsessed I was with learning a new language. I thought it was the coolest thing ever. I didn't know I was going to move to the US. I just knew that learning English was very, very important when it came to finding jobs, even in Colombia. It's very important that you know English. And that is something that I knew from very, very young. And also, my dad knew how to speak English, not as good as he does now, but pretty well. He could communicate in English and he had great job opportunities just because of that. Once I got the news in sixth grade when I was about 12 years old that we were moving to the United States, I was obviously terrified, but I was very excited because I had studied English. I was really good, or I had really good grades in English. But remember, this was mainly textbook English and listening to English from non-native speakers. So I didn't really know what it was going to be like once I actually started speaking with Americans. Well, it all started when I moved here and I was in seventh grade. It was really difficult to understand anything that was said. I remember sitting in school thinking, I don't know what it means to take my book out or do the homework, or I didn't know what any of that meant. And at times I was behind on schoolwork because I was lost. I didn't know the instructions from the teacher. It was a very confusing time, but I didn't let that get me down. At first, I only hung out with other Spanish speakers to make me feel more at home. And I never really practiced English as much in the beginning because it was really scary. After the first year in school and after I moved to another school, I remember being in the back of the car with my siblings. And we promised each other that we would never speak Spanish between us ever again. And we still hold true to that to this day. We don't speak Spanish between each other. It's really weird. But because of that change, our English just went up. We knew that we needed to learn English quickly. First, because we didn't want to do bad in school. And second, we wanted to make friends that speak English. We wanted to, you know, become a part of the school, you know, be able to assimilate to the culture. And it was very hard when we couldn't speak English. After that feeling of, okay, I have me and my siblings, we are all in this together. Then also my dad was a part of it. We started only speaking English with him or trying to, so that we could improve our English much quicker. If you are already an adult, I would suggest speak to your kids in English. That's what we did, and my dad's English also got a lot better just from speaking English with us. These are just a few changes that I'm making so that my English could get better. I don't know how I decided these things. It was more of like an impulse, an intuition that I need to make these changes to actually see progress. Another change that I made was that I decided to participate more in class. And with that, I started reading out loud in the classes because I wanted to improve the way that I pronunciate things. I knew I wasn't pronouncing anything perfectly, but I would listen to my classmates and I would copy them and try to speak like them. So I was acting like a parrot. I would listen and I would repeat it. I would follow along in the book, and that helped my confidence like improve a lot more. I knew that I wasn't a perfect speaker, English speaker, but I did my best. I tried and it paid off. These little changes started paying off. The biggest change had yet to come. In 10th grade, we moved to Nashville, Tennessee, which is where I am now. And in 10th grade, it is a very difficult time to change schools, change friends. I was 16, I believe, turning 16 years old, the worst age, but it was the greatest change that helped me become a fluent native speaker. The circumstances weren't the best, but we went to a school that didn't have any Spanish speakers, maybe one or two, but never met them. So I was forced to speak English as fluent as possible. As you know, high school is very tough. It is very hard to get along with new students that you didn't know before. And a lot of these kids knew each other from elementary school. I was new. I still had a very heavy accent. I didn't understand 100% of everything that was going on, but I made it my mission to speak English like everybody else. It was honestly the hardest part of my life, but it definitely pushed me to the max. At first, my entire sophomore year, all of 10th grade, I was very quiet. People didn't understand why I was so quiet. I'm not really the quiet type, like super quiet, but I didn't want to expose the way that I spoke English. I thought I have a really heavy accent. Nobody understands me. I'm just gonna be quiet. And that is the worst thing that you can do. After my 10th grade year of being quiet, then it came my junior year in 11th grade, and I didn't care anymore. So I started speaking more and just letting English roll out of my tongue however way it came. I didn't care. I started seeing improvements. I didn't care, but I started hanging out with people that accepted me how I was, and it was a lot easier for me to learn from them because I wasn't just a passive learner, like sitting there listening. I became an active learner. So I started speaking more and more and more, making mistakes that made everybody laugh, but I ended up learning. So if I didn't know something, I would ask them, hey, I don't know what this means. And they would explain it to me in English because I was at the level that I could understand if somebody explained it to me or by context. So that is what really, really helped me become more of a native English speaker. So for the remainder of high school and college, I just carried that on and I started mimicking the way that they spoke so that I could pronounce things a lot better. And now I am able to share what I learned during those very tough years with you guys. And I'm really, really happy to be able to share this with other people who may be in the same situation. You may be in school or you are already an adult, but I would suggest look for those ways that you can make small changes to your daily life so that you can make huge improvements. And again, this is my personal experience of in the context of me moving to the US when I was in middle school. Everybody has moved to the US at different ages. My mom, for example, she moved in her mid-30s and learning English was a lot harder for her than it was for me. And same for my dad. We're all different. But I did want to share with you my personal experience so that you can maybe take some tips and tricks away from my story that can apply to your English learning story. If you have any questions, comments, or would like me to share with you a tip that I mention in more detail, just let me know, comment below, and I will be happy to go over the comments and these questions and answer to the best of my ability. Don't miss free Go Natural English tips by signing up for our email at gonaturalenglish.com/email. I'm so happy to be a part of Go Natural English. I will be sharing more videos like this with tips and tricks. Some videos will be more focused to one topic than other, but the idea is to help you become more fluent. Don't forget to check out our English course, and I will see you next time in my next video. Bye.